Chi-Town Constrictors. Today is January 2nd, and our female that we've been following is ovulating today. She's got a full-sized football, a full ovulation, so as of today, we're going to start a 123-day countdown. She's going to probably go into a shed cycle, at which point we'll start a 105-day countdown. That'll help us predict our due date, but she is here in full ovulation. Why don't we take a look? So here she is, and if you get a real good up-close look, you can see how big she is. Real swollen. It's why it's called a football ovulation, because it looks like she swallowed a football. She's gotten a lot bigger progressively over the last 8 hours, and she will probably even continue to get bigger for the next couple of hours. This is going to last for roughly 16, 18, maybe as many as 24 hours, and then she's going to go right back down to normal size. I'm going to try and get my hand in here so you can see exactly how big she is. I don't want to mess with her too much, but you can see how big and swollen she is. It looks very uncomfortable, but that's it. That's the big ovulation that we've been building up and hoping for. So taking a look back at everything, she's been breeding since the first week of September. So she bred all of September, all of October, all of November, and all of December. 4 months of breeding. That takes a harsh toll on any male that you're breeding, whether it's a young male especially, you have to be very careful with young males, or even an older male. Older males, 4 months of consistent breeding takes a lot of work. And I think that's why, as you guys saw in the last video, the original male that I had put with her, I think just ran out of gas. I've still tried to rotate him in, and he has taken no interest in her whatsoever and will not go back to breeding her at all. That's why I had to introduce a secondary male to continue breeding her and push her over the limit to get to today, where she ovulated. Looking back at my notes, that second male has been breeding her for the entire last month. So my honest prediction is that that secondary male, being the VPI IMG Sunglow Jungle, which is a visual-to-visual pairing, I think he's probably going to sire most of, if not the entire litter. So majority of this litter is probably going to be visual VPIs. If there's anything at all that's not a visual, I know it's going to be from the original male. But based on the fact that he was breeding her for the entire last month, has the freshest sperm in her right before ovulation, my prediction is going to be that he's going to sire probably the entire litter. As I pointed out a minute ago, with her ovulation being today, January 2nd, that means her due date is going to be 123 days from today, which actually calculates to May 5th, Cinco de Mayo. So we're going to go ahead and celebrate. Cinco de Mayo hopefully is going to be a good day. She's going to have hopefully a shed coming up here soon. It's going to be a shed cycle that takes a little bit longer. It usually takes about 18 days or so. And then once that shed comes off, we can recalculate, which is 105 days. Those dates don't always coincide from the ovulation date to the post-ovulation shed date. Usually they're 2 to 3 days off. In my experience, the shed date is the more accurate of the two dates. Actually, I think my last 6 litters have all been exactly on their due date according to the post-ovulation shed. So we're going to keep monitoring her. We're going to see where this goes. I'll keep you guys updated when she has her shed. Through the gestation period, I'm going to go ahead and ultrasound her, and we'll see if she's got good babies or slugs. And then hopefully sometime around Cinco de Mayo, we're going to be looking at some pretty cool babies. Hope you guys enjoyed this one. I'll see you guys next time. I can't